unfortunate thing is we keep talking Fraser, 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 Fraser. And like I ran the numbers on Fraser today. And the thing about him is he's a freak show.
Okay.
So the problem is we need to talk about the other 99% of athletes, because when I went back and checked Fraser's numbers, so I told you I went back because I have nothing else to do right now because I have a newborn baby. I went back and ran one rep max events in the games, and I ran how those standings would change if it was based off of percent of body weight.
Okay.
And I did it for three of them. The standings weren't rocked as much as you would think it would be if we base it off body weight.
Okay.
The person that has a huge gripe with this would be Cody Anderson.
True.
Cody Anderson is the one should actually be making this argument. And again, I'm making your point for you. Cody Anderson said, I'm never going to compete unless I get stronger. I'm not going to do a burpee for the next 2 years. Right. And I'm just going to focus on getting stronger.
And he did, but he's still
And he
not.
Did, but I still, I'm still not convinced he could compete at a high level with weightlifting events at the games.
I agree. I feel like he's in the top half.
Probably.
Before a guy that is as small as he is, top half is a pretty good spot to be, I would say.
Yeah. Now, when I went back and ran the numbers on this, Fraser, in regards to percent of body weight, is still right exactly where you'd expect him to be, if not higher. Okay. He still just moves unreal weights. The other guy that popped off the page for me that was kind of crazy was Scott Panchik.
Yeah. Yeah.
Scott Panchik only weighs 187 pounds and is easily one of the 10 strongest guys in the field every year.
Terrible. But no, I don't like the idea of testing it to body weight because, and this is, I'm a heavier person. So the idea of me lifting double my body weight and Spieler lifting double his body weight, I feel like is a far more achievable thing for Spieler than it is for me.
Right.
I have to lift almost 500 pounds.
Right. Exactly. And yeah, it's, you're never going to overhead squat 500 pounds, right? So, yeah. And then, or 480 or whatever. But then the other side of that too, and just to argue against my own point, and because I've gotten into arguments with this about people in the gym many times, where they're like, they make the body weight argument towards me. Like, oh, you snatched 250. Well, you're 60 pounds heavier than me. And I'm like, yeah, dude, I'm 60 pounds heavier than you because I'm bigger and stronger than you too. Yeah. Like that is a part of it.
Like I'm a big person, but like I try and also be big and also fit at the same time. It's not an accident that you look that way or you can move that weight. Like you could have just sat on the couch for the last 10 years of your life, been
very specific test of strength among hundreds, right? Yeah. Like someone explained to me why we couldn't have a field like at Strongman's Fear, right? 10 lanes on the grass, and we have 20. Farmer's handles, and we can't tell them work up to a max 100 meter farmer's carry.
So as far like they load the weight and they go.
Yeah,
but I think you're better off going, all right, everybody's got the same weight, go for a minute, how far can you get?
Well, they did that in 2011. Skills one, skills two. Bitch and complain about it for the next year, but then you'll come out next year. Guess what everyone's been doing?
Everybody will be great at it.
Yeah, right?
No, so, I get it. I get there's 100 better ways to test strength than they do right now. You could freaking pull a bus. Just watch a strongman competition for 5 minutes and you could find better ways to test strength.
Right. You could do a car deadlift or they keep dropping weights into like the
– Yeah.
That'd be awesome. Oh, man, I would love it. It would be expensive and very – and the problem is like scaling. Mm-hmm. Scaling as far as like you need to have 40 or 50 individuals that can do it within, you know, a 2 hour time frame. But like the thing where like they drop the weights and they do the rack pulls or like, you know, a cage carry, something like that.
Keg toss
would be awesome, right? I don't know if I can think of a better test of just raw power than throwing a keg over that pole vault thing.
You could easily figure out a way to make that work for 4 heats of 10 people.
Oh yeah, well, and the thing I've been saying forever too that they I wish they would do is a true Atlas Stone.
Like, Like just the heavy Atlas stone, can you get it up on
no platform? Like the way they do it in Strongman, where you have five platforms, you have five stones of ascending weight and descending platforms, and it's a race to get it up there. So again, that's a true test of strength, but and like a bigger, stronger athlete will do better, but there is an element of speed and technique involved that would give other athletes an opportunity.
Oh, man, I want to know the differences that they would have for those platforms for an Atlas stone. You got like 6'9" guys in strongman. You got 4'11" guys.
I guess you could say that. The image that keeps coming to my head is the event from, I believe, 2012. But I could be wrong on that. Where they did the handstand. Maybe it's 2011. Where they did the double unders and overhead squats straight into handstand push-ups and a sled push. And just the image that keeps coming to my head is seeing Chris Buehler cram his noodle against the sled that triple his body weight.
Yeah.
And he's pushing that thing down his lane. And the whole, and like when you see that, you're like, this dude is not weak. Yep. But this dude is going to take bottom 10 in any strength event that they throw at him. Because the sport has become selective. You know?
I mean, yeah, I don't know.